Hi, this is Dr. Frederick. So I have a data set here that somebody gave me that they would like for me to show them how to do some of the confidence interval work in PHSTAT. The first thing we want to do is just make really clear what is what. And so we don't have that clarity, but let's just assume that the left column are the X values and the right column are the Y values, and then let's work from that. So we have, like 50 values, something like that. And we want to regress these values, regress y on x, and see the relationship there. And what we're going to do is just use PHSTAT, use regression, simple linear regression. Then we have these choices. Let's get a scatter plot. Let's get the confidence intervals. Let's select our y values here. Okay. And then we're going to select our x values there. And then first cells have a label in them. That's right. We're going to get scatter plot. And then let's just say for something like x equals 30, let's find the predicted y value at 90% confidence. Okay, so let's go to our plot, our scatter plot. And when let's make this bigger here. Format the axis. It looks like about 20 is the lowest x value and 75 is the highest. Okay, and so then the lowest y value is about 15, the highest is about 40. So we'll get this. All right, so we said, tell us what the value of y is probably going to be when x is 30. And that's what this line tells, the regression line. It just said, well, I find 30 on this line. Here's the value. It's 25, maybe a little bit more than 25. And that's what the regression line says. Okay, tell me the predicted value of y when x equals 50. Well, it's like 27, something like that. And here is how it figures that out. It says take, 0.05 times my x value and add 23.573, and that's how it gets the predicted values. Okay, so now what we're interested in is, well, I want to, say what's the likelihood that the y value is actually in such and so a range with a certain level of confidence. So we said find the y value, the predicted y value when x equals 30. We want our confidence to be 90%. And it says your predicted y value is going to be 25.1. Now, here are all the values that are in your book to show you how to compute a confidence or prediction interval. There's your H statistic, your T value, your standard error of the estimate is 3.82. And you're going to plug all that into a formula, and you're going to get something called a half width. All it says is add or subtract this from the predicted value. Okay, the predicted value minus 1.5 is 23.5. The predicted value plus 1.5 is 26.5. Okay, and then for the confidence interval, for the prediction interval, it's much wider. Okay, for you want an individual prediction. The standard example always used is, what are the stickers tell you on the side of a car about the gas mileage? Well, those are the predicted values for the car. It's the average values. And you want to say, how much is a car going to get? Well, it's going to get not 25 miles a gallon. It's going to get somewhere between 23.5 to 26.5 miles per gallon, right? With 90% confidence. I'm 90% confident that any car I pick out of this brand with this rating is going to get this. Now I'm going to say, what about this particular car that I pick out of the lot? This particular car, the prediction interval for an individual response is much wider. There's much more variability associated with that. And so here the half interval is 6.6, and you see minus from 25.1 is 18.5 and adding 31.6. So 90% confident that this this particular car, the one I'm pointing to right now, will get this gas mileage with 90% confidence. Could be much higher, could be much lower, but any car on the lot, I just want to know for the average car, it's going to be, you know, much, much smaller range. So this is what the data are telling you in PHSTAT. Now, probably have to do the whole thing over again. Let's just go ahead and do the whole thing over again and look at just one other issue here. So the question that I have for you is, let's get our Y's. Let's get our X's. Let's get our, we don't need scatter plot anymore. Let's get our confidence interval for X equals 30. What will Y be? But now we want more confidence. Now the question is the interval going to be larger or smaller? And the answer is, if you want more confidence, you have to pick up more and more values. You know, if you were 100% confident about the value of Y, the predicted value of Y from your X value, you would pick any potential Y value. A range from zero to whatever the highest could be, 100 miles a gallon. That would be 100% confidence. You have certainty that the answer is somewhere in that range. Well, do you have any information? No. That's not useful information. So to get useful information, you have to give up confidence. And so for a 95% confidence interval, you know, the range is going to be wider. Here the half is not 1.5, but 1.8. Here it's not 6.7, but 7.9. So increasing confidence makes the intervals larger. Okay, so the T value is going to be larger. That's one of the reasons. I mean, that's, I think, probably the only reason, okay? All right, if you have any further questions on this issue, please post them and I will be glad to address it.